Wow. So phase three released this morning, and there have been a lot of things going on. Like, there's a ton to talk about, and there's a lot to get to in this video, and I'm going to hit as many points as I possibly can as we go through and digest all of the different subjects related to the launch and release of Phase 3. And as always, please do be sure to share any and all experiences that you guys are having with me in the comment section down below so I can have a conversation with you about them. And without any further ado, let's go ahead and dive into our conversation about the launch of Phase 3. Now, before we go any further into this subject, I do want to go ahead and clarify that nothing that we're talking about here is at all in any way about bashing the devs, okay, guys? We are here to leave feedback, but we're not here to say, oh, I don't like the developers because this, or I don't like the developers because that. We are solely here to leave feedback and help make the game better as it grows, and I hope that we can do a good job of that as a community. Now, let's talk about the elephant in the room here, which is the console mod related bug. Now, basically what that is it's actually not a bug. It was an intentional limitation put in on the console mods for a specific reason. Now, this particular community manager said, hey everyone, thanks for all your Season 3 feedback today. We are reading it all and already working on encountered issues. Overall, we understand that the mod memory limit on consoles has been an important problem for many of you. Bringing mods to console was a lot of work, but also something we are extremely happy about, both in relation to our work and modders' creations. However, it is also something that comes from a different system, which caused more in-game crashes than planned. In order to limit these crashes and improve your gaming experience, we have had to put a stronger mod limitation on PS4 and Xbox in today's patch. Now, they finish by saying, we hear that it's causing issues for some of you, so please keep on providing us with your constructive feedback so we can move forward. Now, while I do agree that the fact that they've had to impose a stricter mod limit is unfortunate, I do understand why, because I remember a lot of people in my comments asking why won't, say for example, this particular map work, or after I enabled this particular mod, my game was crashing, and what they're trying to do is they're trying to minimize those experiences, right? So if you need to have only one or two or three mods on in order to make that a reality, then it seems like that might be what they're going for. At the end of the day, they're trying to make the game play better and make your experience smoother. However, in reading my comments on the earlier Phase 3 related video, I did see a lot of people saying that now my game is crashing, I had a bunch of mods on, and now when I try to load into my game, it crashes, and that is, again, like I said before, extremely unfortunate. Now, briefly, I'd like to revert back to that previous statement, and they also said if you experience memory issues with mods, the first thing to do is clear your mod library. Go to your mod browser, more, and cleanup, and they said you may want to sell your mods first in case you're worried about losing the in-game cache. However, again, in my comment section, I've had some players saying that they can't even get into their save game, and when you have an issue like that, please do report it directly to the developers, and literally just report what the issue is, report what it's doing, and they have said that they are working on fixes as we speak. Now, in some other mod-related news, some people were asking me in the comments earlier about the iX3880 and why it had temporarily disappeared from the mod dashboard, and the reason for that is because the creator, Puppy Master, actually recently pushed a Phase 3-related update directly related to logging so that that truck can haul the logging equipment that you're actually seeing here on the 512. Now, this save right there, I was very proud of that. I was like, oh, I'm going over. And then there just so happened to be a usable winch point over there, and I was like, I'm actually not going over. And to talk about the 512, just for a brief moment, this hill climb actually really surprised me. Even though it doesn't have all-wheel drive, it does have lockers in both of those rear axles, and with the 51-inch tires going up this hill, it actually did a really, really, really good job. Now, next up, there's another very, very, very involved section of this video that we're gonna go ahead and move into now, and that is the initial patch notes for Phase 3 and today's update release. Now, stick with me, because there is a lot of them. Now, new content first, beginning with paid DLCs, are the new region, which is Wisconsin, featuring two maps, Black Badger Lake and Greenwoods River. Paid DLC truck, the International Paystar 5600 TS. Paid DLC truck, the Boar 54318. Paid DLC truck, Pacific P512 PF. And paid DLC new skins for the Step 310E, Voron Grad, and Royal BM17. And then free updates are two new trials, free logging contracts for both new and base game maps, free logging add-ons, free curtains and windshield stickers added as customization options, and free additional customization elements for all trucks, meaning additional added stickers. General additions supported an adjustable low range for special gearboxes. Music sets on maps are now played in random order, and added an ability to remove on-map trailers via the functions menu, which again is basically trailer deleting, which we saw in the PTS. Moving on now to general fixes. Fixed a bug where trucks that were left on a bridge could get stuck when the game was relaunched. I experienced that personally. Fixed a bug where the starting engine message appeared when the player tried to winch another player's car with a stopped engine. Fixed a camera shake that happened when a player used any of the move crane buttons for a crane of the KRS-58 Bandit truck. Beacons on trucks are now disabled by default. Beacon state is now saved. Fixed a bug in the task tools for the warehouse in Big Salmon Peak, where the player approached the objective curtain side trailer for the first time, it jumped out of the ground. Improved winch attachment point for the heavy rock trailer. Fixed a bug where objective trailer and vehicle was discovered again after a task restart. Added oil stains in the water where the player's truck is, which is a very cool touch. Fixed a bug where in some cases points shown in the garage to unlock stuff were wrong and not tied to the actual player's rank. Fixed a bug where the sound of anchors was looped if the truck was changed when the anchors were moving. Fixed a bug in co-op where the host could invite players despite the game's player limit being maxed out. Fixed a bug where the crane of the KRS-58 Bandit truck was rotating in some cases after entering the truck if the crane was rotated at 180 degrees before. Very odd and very specific bug there. Fixed a bug where destination markers were placed after rotating a map. Fixed a bug where the distance was not converted in gallons/miles metric system in missions that involve the seismic vibrator. Disabled blur for on-map trucks where a player drives nearby. Fixed a bug where the third slot of the managed party menu was unlocked while the game was limited to two players. Fixed a bug where a crane was not fully restored for other players in the co-op game. Finally, coming to the last two now from this section, fixed a bug where sometimes players were unable to scroll through the truck list in the upgrade obtained window, and fixed a bug where framing zones and buildings desynced between host and client. Moving on now to mod browser and modding related fixes, we have added unsubscribe confirmation pop-up, fixed a bug where the option sorting by the name was inverted alphabetical order by default, fixed a bug where the mod report description window was limited to 30 characters. Fixed a bug where in some cases, lists of mods that a player needs to download to join a co-op game was not complete. Fixed a bug where mods were available in Truck Store for a client in co-op sessions without mods. Fixed a bug where co-op game invitations did not work in the mod browser and after leaving the mod browser. Fixed a bug where with a certain amount of mods activated, the player could start a single player game, but not a co-op game. Moving on to modding specifically, fixed a bug where the vehicles found counter did not increase when the player found vehicles on the mod map, added additional mod verification checks in the game editor packaging process, supported custom employers' names, supported the purchase of any trucks from different regions in custom scenarios, mod creators are now able to create add-ons with a mobile watchtower functionality, mod creators are now able to set up default player level and amount of money in custom scenarios, which is great, map mod creators are now able to set up custom prices in the garage, which is very cool. A memory limit has been implemented for mods to improve performance while playing with mods. This system will be improved through iterations in future updates. So the way that feature is now is not its final state. Console specifically added an option to disable Casiva, and moving on even from that, which basically that's just a little set of numbers at the bottom of the screen. Video settings are now properly restored to default, motion blur, film grain, and sharpening. Fixed a bug where video settings were reset to default after the game restart. Fixed a bug where the title did not display a appropriate system dialogue where a user with the you can see the upload community creations privilege set to block attempted to access user generated content. And map specifically added a highlight for the manual loading in the quarry area on the Smithville Dam level in Michigan, fixed a bug where players could not restart the lost instrument task in Zimnogorsk, and finally, truck section tweaked mirrors placement for the Western Star 49X and tweaked winch connecting point for the Bandit's crane. Now, that was quite a mouthful. Those are all of the patch notes released in today's update. Now, if you want to read all those patch notes specifically and in depth, I will leave a link in the description box down below to the developer's official release. Now, in closing, please remember that the updates made today were made from the standpoint of trying to improve the game's performance and experience and avoid future crashes. And I know that that might be hard to sort of internalize at the moment because I understand how frustrating it can be to have your game glitch or have bugs or have crashes. I've had them happen to me myself. But please remember that the devs are just trying to make the game experience a better experience and a smoother experience for you guys. And we can only help them by giving them our honest feedback. So, with that being said, let me know any thoughts and opinions you guys have about this in the comment section down below. And if you enjoyed, please do consider hitting that subscribe button and turning those notifications on. And I will see you guys in the next one. Talk to y'all later.